Jabba Chukiba is in the process of making some illegal genetic experiments, including Experiment 621, Chop Suey, and Experiment 626, Stitch. Just take the teleporter, dude. Apparently, 626 experiments weren't good enough for big old Jamba, so Stitch has to travel to different worlds to go and collect some DNA for his experiments. Meanwhile, Chop Suey's a bit jealous that Jamba likes Stitch more than he does, so he's up to something devious. We'll get to what that something is in a bit. Stitch's DNA collection attracts the attention of an evil scientist named Dr. Happy Trail. Not to be confused with Dr. Hamsterville, who you see later in the franchise. Seriously, I did the same thing at one point. Stitch eventually finds Happy Trail's lab, and Happy Trail, not happy that Stitch is here, breaks out a giant robot. What are you, Dr. Eggman? But when it comes to giant robots, you all know how it goes at this point. Back to DNA collecting for Stitch. Chop Suey takes the DNA that Stitch had collected for Jamba, and he uses it on a machine called a mutator, turning him into a horrific monstrosity.
Now we stop this.
Little Green Monster ain't little no more. Just when Chop Suey is defeated, the Galactic Federation and their captain Gantu show up, arresting both Jamba and Chop Suey. Stitch infiltrates Galactic Federation HQ and breaks Jamba out of prison, eventually confronting Gantu himself. Stitch puts the big dummy on ice, and Stitch and Jamba escape Galactic Federation custody. What happens next? Well, you're gonna have to watch the movie. And the second movie, and the third movie, and the TV series, and the fourth movie. But do yourself a favor and skip the anime.